Hey, do you want to have full control over your surface? That's what's coming up now. This is a follow-up on the last video where we talked about surface tweening, surface matching, merging, matching edges, and so on. And there was some problems with deformability where flat surfaces didn't behave the same as already smooth surfaces, and exactly that we will look into today. So, upcoming now, rebuilding surfaces. Refitting surfaces and really getting the full control over your surface and down to the point and the control points of the surfaces. Okay, so surface tools, we are in this section here. We will cover these 6 points. Rebuilding surfaces, rebuilding surface UI. It's very similar. It's just even more control than the first one. Refit surfaces to a tolerance. The degree of surfaces, very important, very important. Split and merge edges and rebuilding edges. So, for example, I have a surface like this, and I want to deform it. How does that work? Well, so I can add division points. Sorry, we can add divisions to this because at the moment we have only these edge points as control points. We can change this, but if we want to deform it more, like for example the center, then we need to add more control points. So let's do that. We can add it by insert not in that case. So let's do this. And I add here one in the center, here, here. And then I flip the direction. We talked about this in the past. Hope you can remember. And I keep, yeah, no, let's do this like this. Now I basically created more control points. And now if I do this, it's not really a control point. It behaves almost like a vertices on a mesh, like mesh modeling. That's how it behaves. And I will just copy this. This is better. So with this tool, we can rebuild the surface with the same or more amount of control points. Ah, sorry, this one, the rebuild surface. Okay, you can see now. Okay, this is the preview is already on. You can see how that would deform the surface, and it's counting the points it has for each direction, in each direction. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That was the original. And now it would go down to 4. If I make it even less, then it will change back to a flat surface. See? This was basically saying, okay, I reduce the amount of surface points and I get this. And I can add more and more surface points if I want. So if I want to have the same amount, then it would look like this. So let's do this again. So that would be the smooth version of that surface. However, there are actually more control points because now you can see the control points of the surface. I will copy this here so we can play with that a bit more. Going back here, I want to show a bit more. So there is also another option here. It's called degree. The degree just changes the curvature of the surface. And I think you just need to play a bit with it. It's not that obvious because it feels like. So if I want to match the same isocurves, the same amount of isocurves as this one. Nevertheless, so you can play with that, so to try to fit your original surface. We can also add more control points, of course, to get closer to the original. The more points we add in both directions, the closer it could get to that original shape. You can add 100 points. And here, let's say 50. It's a bit too much. Let's Do 50 here as well. 25 and 50, let's say. It basically, the more points you add, the more closer you get to this shape, but a soft version, of course. And then the surface degree doesn't really matter that much anymore. It doesn't change much of the surface. It's just slightly different. So I hope it's clear. I will go back and make it a bit more obvious that we used this. Let's make only 15 and 30. And by the way, you have the options to delete input and retrim. So you can, if you don't delete the input, you just create another surface. Rebuilding surface UI is very similar. The only difference is that you have more control over the direction. So you can, for example, here, you can individually change the control points in one direction. So for example, in the V direction, I can have a different point count, or just control the point count for that direction. So let's say 40. What it also does, it's actually pretty cool because you can keep the degree. You can actually see that the U direction degree is still segments, but the Y direction is smooth. Okay, so let's do this. I will copy these. Refitting surfaces, this tool tries to match the current shape of the surface, but lowering the amount of division points. So in this one, for example, I will not go through all the options here, but you can set the tolerance on how this is the accuracy. Let's do 0.1, and you can see it tried to lower the amount of surface of division points. Didn't really work. Well, let's do it with less. So so for example, if I use only one as a fitting tolerance, and I keep the degree as it is, keep the degree with two or with three for in both directions, then yeah, it just tries to basically reduce the amount of control points, but at the same time keep the same shape as much as possible. It's actually pretty useful. So can do that again, and let's use 0.5, and wait, let's change the degree. No, 0.5, let's change the degree also. Let's make it lower and the tolerance 0.5. let's see what's happened. Okay, it's not much less really, but you can see that especially in this direction it was able to reduce the amount of division points. I will go back and do it again with the settings I had before. Let's say 0.8. Yeah. I can also change the surface degree. That's a very important tool. So let's go back here to this one where I didn't have much chance with this tool. If I use this on that surface, because the degrees doesn't work, the degree doesn't fit to that. I cannot use that tool on this surface. So I will try that. So if I use that tool, I will change the surface degree to 2 and 2 and the fitting tolerance to 0.8 as we had before. But do this, refitting, 0 surfaces refit. So it didn't even do the process. But I can change the degree of the surface. Let's change the degree to 2 in U direction and V direction. Now it's changed to a deformable surface. Deformable means it's kept the same amount of isocurves, as you can see here, and it just added the division points, and it's very similar to this one. So now we can use all the other tools as well on that surface. But that changes a lot. That changes the complete behavior of that surface. Splitting edges. That's also an interesting thing. So we can split edges. For example, for whatever reason or ever, I want to split this edge here. I can use this tool, split edge. I can choose a point wherever I want to split it, or more points. And now I have edge points here. And the same works also for merging surface, merging edges. You can merge edges by using this tool. That means it's basically removing these division points again. Could be quite useful in certain situations. So you cannot merge this edge with that edge. It need to be a smooth edge chain in order to do that. But yeah, there could be some really interesting. If we then have this tool, we will get to that. This is a special tool, solid points on. Then we actually see these division points, and we can change them. But yeah, that's what you can do. Now the merging might not work anymore. So now if I want to merge these, then that might not work. Yeah, no. Now they are kind of broken, so I can't really merge them anymore. I will go back and I will do the same on that. You see, if I turn the solid points on, there is no division points here. So let's do that again. Adding division points. Let's make it easier for the. Actually, you can see that there is a division here. So actually now you could see that there is a problem if I want to merge, let's say I want to merge because I cut this object here, and you saw that there are now two edges, they're not continuous. So I actually can see it when I use this tool. There's either this one, there are two edges because it's somehow split at that point. So now if I go here, it only shows the first segment, but if I go on the whole edge, then it and now it should be okay. Anyway, I'll do this again, what I did before. I'm adding division points just for fun. Two division points, and now if I use my solid point tool, I can change this, hopefully. Yeah. Pretty weird. Okay, last one. This is a quick video, hopefully. So, for example, you have a model and then you join the edges and they are not aligned. They're not on the same position. Rhino will give you this warning. It says joining these edges require joining tolerance of 1.6 joints. Do you want to continue? Yes. Okay, let's continue. Now, this is a problem because as you can see, it joined this edge, but it didn't join the other edges. That doesn't work. You cannot extend. So, although it doesn't matter at the moment, if I explode that again, then I could end up with something like this, where a surface kind of lost its the complete edges and it has this gap here. Then you can use this rebuild edges. And again, there's like you can choose the tolerance, do this, and done. Rebuild edges. I like this one. That's pretty cool. All right, I hope you enjoyed this lesson. Next time we will look into. Yeah, we go from here. We will untrim. We did stuff of this already. We try to cover all these. I think it's good to really go through this very quickly. Here it's some analysis tools to check the curvature, to check the direction of a surface and so on. Edge continuity, interesting stuff. I have used some of these, not all of it. I very often use the show edge tools. And then, great, then we can move on to solids. I know we did part of it already, but we will do it a bit more in depth. And then Boolean unions and so on. Oh my god, there's really a lot of stuff coming up. Meshes, we'll deal meshes on a completely separate. We will go through all the NURBS first and then we go into meshes. So we will skip meshes a bit and go through all these here. Exploding, trimming, grouping. There might be some lessons. They're very short. Arrays are very interesting. Transforming, text, history settings. I never use history, but I should. And there's more. So that's all upcoming. It's a huge, vast universe, this Rhino universe. Okay, see you next time.